Thank you. Good morning. We thank God for all the praise team this morning for being with us, and our musicians for being with us on this Sunday morning. Happy Mother's Day. This is Mother's Day Sunday, and we bless God for all of the mothers. Amen. If you're out there listening to us on this morning, we ask you, why don't you just give God a hand clap of praise. Amen. This Sunday morning, amen. It's a blessing to be in the house of the Lord one more time. And we just bless Him for all that He's doing, all that He's done, and certainly all that He's going to do. And through it all, I've come to realize that through every situation, every circumstance, with Jesus on our side, we're going to make it. Can I get a witness out there this morning? I said, with Jesus on our side, we're going to make it. I know somehow, I know some way, we're going to make it. Thank you. late Sunday morning. Truly, this is a day the Lord has made, and we rejoice and be glad, and we're glad in it. Amen. Thank you, Minister Music, and certainly our praise team for joining me with us this morning. Certainly, we thank God for our media specialists with us on this morning as well. We thank God for you. And just thank God for the listening ears that are with us on this morning. I want to talk this morning on this Mother's Day Sunday morning, as well as this is our communion Sunday morning here at First Mount Bethel Missionary Baptist Church in Savannah. And we just want to bless you on this morning.
Amen.
God has blessed us with the word, and we want to give the word to you as God has given to us on this morning. A praying mother and an answering God.
Amen.
A praying mother and an answering God.
Yes.
From the story of Hannah, 1 Samuel, chapter number 1, the story of Hannah, praying mother and an answering God. If you turn to 1 Samuel with us, chapter number 1, you find these words that are there. Amen.
Amen.
The Bible says, now there was a certain man, a Ramathim Zophim, of Mount Ephraim, and his name was Elkanah, the son of Jeroham, the son of Elihu, the son of Tohu, and the son of Zab, an Ephrathite. And he had two wives. The name of one was Hannah, and the name of the other was Peninnah. And Peninnah had children, but Hannah had no children. And this man went up out of his city yearly to worship and to sacrifice unto the Lord of hosts in Shiloh. And the two sons of Eli, Hophni and Phinehas, the priests of the Lord, were there. And when the time was that Elkanah offered, he gave to Peninnah his wife and to all her sons and her daughters portions. But unto Hannah he gave a worthy portion, for he loved Hannah, but the Lord had shut up her womb. And her adversary also provoked her sore for to make her fret, because the Lord had shut up her womb. And as he did so year by year, when she went up to the house of the Lord, so that she provoked her, therefore she wept and did not eat. Go with me down to verses number 17 and 18, and at your own time, if you read these verses, you'll find these words again printed there. Verse 17 says, then Eli answered and said, go in peace, and the God of Israel grant thee thy petition that thou hast asked of him. And she said, let thine handmaid find grace in thy sight. So the woman went her way and did eat, and her countenance was no more sad. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
That word is Peninnah. Amen. Amen. The story of Hannah is most befitting at any time, of which it shares with us the fact that if you pray sincerely, that God will not just hear your prayers, but God will also answer your prayers. Is there a witness listening to me this morning?
Yes, he will.
God hears our prayers, and that's, it should serve for us all that God still hears and answers our prayers. And so first, as we recognize all mothers on this day, mothers past, mothers present, what makes them a mother is that God gifted them with a child.
Yes.
A child in which comes special delivery and delivered by a mother sent by God.
Yes.
Do I have a witness here? And even though there are cases that makes about circumstantial differences, my brothers and sisters, whereby there are times that it just may appear that a mother may still be called a mother, but yet bearing of children. Well, what are you saying here, preacher? I'm saying her heart and desire is strong-willed, that she too can still carry the title and even assume the role by what she does of her actions,
Lord,
of that being called mother.
Glory.
And this is Mother's Day, right?
Amen.
It's the day that special recognition is given to mothers.
Yes.
As an expression of thanks and gratitude for all that you do and all that you've done, for the ways you nurtured and cared for God's gifts, his children.
Yes.
My brothers and sisters, God makes children to be gifts.
Yes.
Am I right about it?
Amen.
And gifts are made to be given. In fact, John 3:16 says, God gifted us with his very own son, Jesus.
Yes.
Am I right about it? Yeah.
Yes.
The psalmist says in Psalms 127, verse number 3, that children are a gift from the Lord, and they should be viewed as a reward. And what specializes this creation? What makes children and motherly relationships so special is that the psalmist also inscribed in his writing not only the just of a child's birth, but that in their creation,
yes,
they were made, this is what makes it so special about a child, they were made in the image of God.
Yes.
I don't know about you, but that's special. That's special. It's Psalms 139 verse 14 says that when a baby is born, they are made fearfully and wonderfully in the image of God.
Yes.
That's special.
Oh, yes.
Therefore, this lets us know that mothers are special.
Yes.
Mothers are blessed to not only, listen to this, carry the gift, but deliver the gift and nurture the gift of life that's been given to them by God. And if I can make this even more clear to some mothers on today, mothers, you are more special than you know. Believe you or may have even been told you're special.
Yes.
You're more special than you may even feel. Because you don't know how many times your child have to call out your name, Mama.
Yes.
Point number one, mothers, you are special. Why are you special? You're special because you were gifted to carry this title of that of mother. Gifted to conceive and deliver what comes from God.
Yes.
And the second Sunday in May doesn't do just truly. It doesn't compare to the other 364 days where the real motherhood takes place.
Amen.
Am I talking to anybody this morning?
Yes.
I said, one day out of the year can't even compare to the other 364 days in which mother is taking care of business as being that of a mother. This is Mother's Day, isn't it?
Yes.
But this also ought to be in every mother a day of feeling grateful.
Yes.
This ought to be a grateful day to mothers. Mothers ought to relax and kick back and breathe. In fact, Mother's Day ought to be your waiting to exhale day. And if you're still in the raising, nurturing business or not, or maybe you've emptied the nest, this day is the day that you can exhale.
Yeah.
Relax and thank God for counting you worthy of carrying his gift of life.
Yes.
Do I have a witness in here?
Amen.
Why? Because being a mother is special. And if you're one nurturing, raising, past or present, every mother deserves to know of her exceptional role that she plays in the business of God in creation. Can I say this? I don't know one man that will stand in line or stand in your place in the delivery room to take on this role as that of a mother. I just don't know. I don't know one man that would be willing to go into the delivery room and deliver one of God's gifts. It takes a special mother.
Yes.
To stand in got the responsibility to be called mother. It takes a real mother to realize that mothering comes after the delivery, after the first this, and after the first that. That comes with not only human wisdom, but giving the child some spiritual wisdom as they grow. And when mothers give children spiritual wisdom, it pleases God. Therefore, it is that mothers are included in the proverbial law of raising children. You do know the proverbial law, don't you? When Solomon addresses children being reared, Solomon said in Proverbs 22:6, he said, mothers and mothers' motherly input is included in that task. Yes. I want to say that off the record. Now, mothers are included when Solomon speaks. He don't give a certain person, but he said, train up a child.
Yes, yes.
Have I got a witness here? Yes. He did exclude mothers from the process. Solomon didn't specify one of the parents, but Solomon said, train up a child in the way that she goes. And the NIV version says this: star children on the way that they should go.
Yes.
And even when they're old, he said, they will not turn from it. And so unmentioned, unspecified, mothers, you are included in that training up of a child. And so we bless God today for mothers, because it was mom that probably trained us how to eat our first meal by ourselves. It was mother that probably taught us how to tie a shoe.
Yeah.
My second point is, God looks for parents, both father and mothers, to make knowledge of him to the children. I wish I had a witness in here this morning. I said, mothers, you're part of the process of training children to the knowledge of God. In other words, God gifted mothers with children, not just to deliver, but to be also with an ever even closer connection with their raising and the relationship that they have with God. Yes, a whole lot of children are in the church today.
Yeah.
And a whole lot of children church because of their mother. But I have to put it on notice today. Sadly, there's a whole lot of children not in church because of a mother. Am I right about it here? Used to be the church was and would be running over with children, because the mother would see to them coming and learn and know God.
Yes.
Used to be a time where my daddy didn't come. This is Mother's Day.
Yes.
Mothers were beating the door down to get themselves and the children into the four walls of the church.
Yes.
And that was hopes and answered prayers that soon daddy would follow. But the primary interest, my brothers and sisters, was that the child would come to know God.
Yes.
And not only know God, but know God for who he is.
Yes.
And it wasn't, listen to this, it wasn't just for Christmas. It wasn't just for an Easter speech.
Tell
it, Pastor. The children would come to church.
Come on, Pastor.
Am I right about it here?
Yes.
It wasn't just for a carnival that children would all of a sudden show up at the church. Am I right about it here?
Yeah.
I said, if it wasn't for Christmas alone, when the Christmas speeches are being given out and all of a sudden the church is flooded with children,
yeah,
it wasn't just for Easter Sunday morning the kids to put on a new outfit and come and dance around the church in a parade, but hadn't been to the church all year long. It wasn't for that.
Well,
but it was children was in church for Sunday. And all of the participating youth activities.
Yes.
That was the responsibility of a mother.
Yes.
I wish I had a witness in here. But now, seemingly, church and worship of God has been slighted by the commercialization of what the world has to offer. And no matter what's being offered, mothers still have a role in the lives of their children. I'm talking about a praying church. I'm talking about a praying church.
Yes.
And a praying church role of a mother.
Yes.
Lest I keep you this morning, Our message has been pulled from the role in which Hannah, as a praying mother, played in the life of her son Samuel.
Yes.
Do I have a witness in here this morning? In other words, unlike Samson, who was and could be seen as being a child of the promise to his mother, Samuel is best known as a child of prayer to his mother.
Oh.
I wish I could get a witness to that. Let me say that again. I said Samson, who was and could be seen as a child of a promise made to his mother. But it was Samuel who was known as a child of prayer that was given to his mother.
Yes.
In another comparison to that, Samson's birth was foretold early by an angel. But Samuel was asked of God by his praying mother. And if I can let some mother know today, as we recognize and embrace yet another Mother's Day, when you pray, and pray in sincerity,
yes,
God will hear you and answer your prayers. Do I have a witness here?
Yes.
In spite of the physical condition and the affliction that was upon Hannah, she found herself being ridiculed by her inability to give birth to a child.
Yes.
Am I right about it this morning? You remember the story about Hannah.
Yes,
yes, the Bible says that Hannah was the favorite wife of Elkanah.
Yes,
yes, and he belonged to one of the most honorable families of the progeny of Jacob, the Korakites. Am I right about it here? And even though he being a godly man, yes, the custom of this time was that of polygamy. Am I right about it here? Now Hannah being the wife of which he favored, yes, the Bible says that she was barren. Yes, in other words, she was unable to have children.
Yes,
so it is. The speculation says that Hannah was wanting her husband to keep with the custom of time. Yes, may have suggested, am I right about it here, that he seeks another wife, that a son would be born within his lineage. Yes, and in comes the second wife. Can I tell the story this morning? Yes, Penina, of whom nothing more, of that she bore seven children for Elkanah, but in the process of bearing children for Elkanah, the Bible would have us to know that she grieved Hannah with cruelty and a spiritless tongue. Yes, but prayer then as well as now, I want you to know this morning that prayer still has a way of changing situations. And I'm right about it here. I want you to know this morning that there's no problem too big or too small that prayer cannot change. Am I right about it this morning? Point number three, as I close now on this Mother's Day Sunday, I want you to know if I can give point number three, that prayer still works. Am I right about it here? so unique. That song is coming to a Christian. Whatever it is, she didn't waste her time and waste her breath and waste God's time on praying to people that was against her. She didn't waste her time and waste God's time on praying against the leader. So she kept on praying to God to prove her praise. He also put something on today. The effectual and the fervent prayer of the righteous availed to us. Hannah was fervent. She was effectual. And she was faithful to her calling of trusting in God. Mothers, if we're going to be effective today, it begins with God. A praying mother and an answering God. God bless you today. God keep you as our prayers. Happy Mother's Day. We love you.
Church
where we can carry out the spirit of this covenant and the principle of God's word. And now unto him who brought again from the dead, our Lord Jesus, be power and glory forever. Amen. 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 While sitting at the communion table, Jesus had this communicated verbiage with disciples. In Luke 22 and verses 15 through 16, he said, "I have desired to eat this Passover with you before I suffer, for I will not anymore eat thereof until it be fulfilled in the kingdom of God." And then he took the bread and gave thanks and broke it and gave it unto them, saying, "This is my body which is broken for you. This do in remembrance of me." And then likewise also the cup after supper, saying, "This cup is the New Testament in my blood, which is shed for you." This is what Jesus did for us. Gave his life that we might live. In our humanity, we're not able to bless the bread or the wine. But we're going to ask God if he will bless this bread and bless this wine, removing it from a carnal use to a spiritual use. Let us pray. God, we thank you this evening, this morning, as we come, Lord, to say thank you. Lord, we thank you for one more sunny day. Lord, we thank you now for another opportunity to come and to confess our sins unto you. And Lord, we realize this morning that you've given us another opportunity when you touch us with a finger of love. Someone laid down last night, and I'm now laying on the pool again. The Lord, you filled us with one more day of activity, one more day of breath, one more day of sight, one more day of taste, one more day of hearing, one more day to praise the Holy Name. And so God, as we come on this Mother's Day, Lord, we ask you to bless every mother that's listening to me. Bless every mother, Lord, across this world, in the name of Jesus. For Lord, we realize that it's only you that chose a woman, Lord, that she might birth children. And so God, we say thank you this morning for all the mothers across the world today. And what a day, Lord, to come as we come together to partake of the bread and wine, which serves as a symbol to your broken body and your shed blood. And so God, we come now this morning asking you, Lord, to take this bread and take this wine, move it from a carnal position, Lord, and bring it into a spiritual use. And as we take it now, Lord, we do as Paul said, as often as we do this, we show forth your death unto you in turn. But then God, we also say to the people, Paul, before we take this bread and this wine, that we would examine ourselves.
Amen.
Amen.
The Bible wants the devils to know that as they rose up from the table, that they went out into the Mount of Olives, and they went out singing a hymn. And we don't have any mountains to go across, but certainly we have a mountain of problems in our world. We have enough problems in our world to accumulate to a mountain size. And so we have to go into the world singing a hymn. We ask you to remember those that are less fortunate. Remember those that are homeless. Remember those that are jobless. Remember those that don't know God as part of their sin. Remember those that are lost. Remember the families. In the name of Jesus. And we'll be mindful to give God all the praise and the glory in Jesus' name. Thank the Lord with you. God bless you. And God keep you. This is my prayer. Thank you.